The Eagles have arrived in London for the last tournament of the HSBC Sevens World Series. Last year, they shocked the rugby world by winning the London Sevens. This is a homecoming for coach Mike Friday.
We're in the homeland, now we're in London. Last leg of the series. It's been a long year for the boys. As we approach London this weekend and the final leg, boys then can kind of recharge and get ready for what lies ahead, which is exciting.
What lies ahead is the Summer Games. As the defending gold medalist, the Eagles are looking to reclaim the gold. With the disappointing finish from Paris, the Eagles have to finish strong for a better place in Rio.
Each game does matter because you need points to accumulate for the end of the season so then you can stand in a better shot for the Olympics.
I definitely know we have a busy week coming up. Either Wednesday or Thursday will be a really tough practice. I'm excited to see where it takes us going into this weekend because we really need it. We really need to find ourselves and see where we're at.
Training this week is intense.
Wait, come on, get down. Get
After Paris, Nate Ebner was placed on the USA Falcons, a feeder team for the Eagles, so he could get more game time. Ben Leatiaga is called up in his absence.
My last name is Leatiaga, but a lot of people say Lady Gaga, so I'm actually the original Lady Gaga.
Zach Test has been with the Eagles since 2009. He holds the record for most games played. At 26, he's a veteran on the team.
Bang, bang, baby!
You know, teaching them the ins and outs of what's on the field, what's off the field, how they can make their life better. It's about the passion. You know, I wake up every day and I love what I do, and I don't want to give it up for anything. One day, I'm going to have to hang them up, but today's not that day. Tomorrow's not that day. I want to go as long as I can.
Coach Friday has an impressive rugby resume, both as a player and coach. This is his second year as head coach.
He's able to get the best out of all his players. I think he knows exactly what he's doing, whether he needs to be abrasive.
Yeah, well, I have gone off, but I've made the conscious decision. It's time to go off.
Whether he needs to be laid back.
Now, these little mistakes that are happening are the same little mistakes that were happening this time last year. So you need to chill. We need to put things in perspective.
A really good example is Maka plays really well in the red fire.
You stay in the blue fire where you're calm, and then there's a red fire where you're just pumped up. He gets me in that red fire.
Just listening to him go over game film and like you realize how much he knows and like how you can always learn.
We are playing our kickoffs like we're going to catch it. If it bounces back and it bubbles their way, make them do movement and then you can probably take it in the air.
When we watch film, when we watch back film and we pick it apart, you can just see a lot of the games that we win is not because of skill, it's just because we got guys that are just willing to work ethic and beat talent any day.
As the players depart the hotel, rugby fans arrive at Twickenham Stadium.
Here at the London Sevens, you've got 16 different nations represented, everybody sitting together, having a good time, singing their songs, no punches being thrown or anything like that.
It's pretty awesome to have people that are willing to travel around the world. I think I've seen them at every stop since I've been on tour.
So yeah, we love the Sevens, we love the 15s, we follow rugby around the world. My name is Thomas, and my wife's name is Natalia, and we are from Washington, D.C.
So he's gonna glue his fingers together, I'm pretty sure this will. Oh my God, it's beautiful.
Thank you. This was my daughter's suggestion. Dad, you need the tiara, you look terrific in it. And you know, we are gonna cheer our hearts out, scream our heads off, until we get it done.
Rugby fans are fun-loving and, for the most part, respectful. A stark contrast to the soccer hooligans who share this historic stadium.
No fans, no violence, nothing.
No fans, guys.
The rugby fans, it's all a big brotherhood. You know, anywhere you go in the world, you go to a rugby tournament, and you may, you know, be competing against another nation, but after the game is over, you know, have a nice cold one, and everybody's brothers.
Cheers. Cheers.
The tournament comes to an end with the Eagles losing to Scotland, who advanced to win the tournament. Perry Baker scored 4 tries against the almighty All Blacks as USA routed them 42-14. The Eagles took 3rd place, beating Fiji 26-19. After the tournament, the players thank their fans.
I'm proud of the whole team. They've had a really special tournament here.
Perry Baker found Thomas and Natalia and gave them his jersey.
Yes. Hey, my man.
It's a Baker.
Friend? This is my friend. This is my friend.
It's been a long road for the Eagles, but now they'll have some time off. Time to be with their family and recharge. Time for them to heal and refocus.
Eagles on three. One, two, three.
Eagles.
In August, they'll need to be at the top of their game in order to reclaim the gold. Coached by Mike Friday, the USA Eagles have a legitimate chance to shock the rugby world again, this time in Rio.
Come competition time in Rio, we're as prepared as we can be. We're in the best place we can be, and you won't have anything to look back on and say, I wish I'd done that.
When everything clicks together, it is dangerous and it's fun to watch.
And I just like a high from out there, like a high, and it comes right to me.
That's
and he said,
Baker,
and he's holding it, and I'm just like,
that's
no, it's not happening,